Welcome back to CBS This Morning. The drug company Pfizer this morning announced it is asking the FDA for full approval for use of its COVID vaccine. It is currently authorized for emergency use only. Also this morning, there is a brand new initiative to track the coronavirus variants that could threaten our recovery. It involves a partnership between former British Prime Minister Tony Blair's Institute for Global Change, scientists from the University of Oxford, and our own Dr. David Agus through his Ellison Institute for Transformative Medicine. This is just the first of many projects for the partnership, which they're calling the Global Health Security Consortium. And our Dr. David Agus joins us now at the table. He's in my chair because of COVID protocols.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So we're having a little bit of distance here, but we're very happy to welcome you.
This is a milestone. But in the same room.
Yeah.
Ugh. I know.
But this is what gets me. We've all been vaccinated. Yeah. But we still can't all be together.
But these are the CDC rules, right?
No, these are the CBS rules. Four people who are vaccinated can get together.
Which are more powerful than the CDC rules.
Yes, they are, at least in this building.
So we've got the abundance of caution going here.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
This is a big chair if you want to sit down, Tony.
That is you. What can you tell us about this new partnership? Sounds interesting.
It's so exciting and a privilege to work with the group at Oxford and with Prime Minister Blair to actually follow the variants across the globe. Getting countries to share data. You know, historically, countries said, I don't want you to know my variant data because it's a check mark against me. It shows that I'm doing something wrong. Now, if we get them to share it, we'll be able to know what to do with the new boosters for the vaccines, and we know what's going on globally with return to policy. It's going to be important.
And how do you track the variants?
So we do what we call DNA sequencing. So right now, you get a PCR test that says, yes, no, you have the virus. But if we look at the 30,000 letters of the code, we could say, did it change from yesterday? Mm. Did it change from other people in your neighborhood? And if it's starting to change, we need to take notice, and not just notice when a country becomes like India, know in advance that something is starting to happen.
Well, that leads to my next question is what do we know about the variants in India? Are you getting data from there, and can you track the variants?
So the variants in India obviously are much, much more infectious. We saw it explode in India. The number of cases every day are breaking records. What we don't know is what else is happening in India yet, because they're not being totally transparent with all of their data, and that's what we're working on. With all those numbers of cases and the virus replicating or dividing in every patient, more variants are going to happen. The key now is trying to know in advance.
How worried should we be
about India?
And the reason why I was going to ask that same thing, because when it first happened with coronavirus, it was in China.
Yeah.
And we were told, if you haven't been to China, if you don't have anybody who's come from China, you've had no association with China, you don't have to worry in the very beginning. So I think many people just thought, okay, I don't need to worry. How worried should we be that it's happening in India?
Well, until Tuesday, we have planes going back and forth between here and India. And now, if you have a U.S. passport, you can still travel from India back to the United States. So we should be worried. The variants clearly from India are here in the United States.
They have not started
to spread dramatically. But the question is, what's next? The current variants, all of them, South Africa, Brazil, the United Kingdom, India, our vaccines protect against serious illness. They work, and that is tremendously encouraging. That's a really positive sign.
So then one of the big questions is, how do we get the rest of the world access to our vaccines? The Biden administration is supporting this idea to open up the formulas to make the drug companies kind of give up their patent protections and allow generics in those countries. The drug companies are saying that's not actually going to help. It's going to be a manufacturing problem. What's the reality?
Well, when you look at it, J&J, AstraZeneca, and Pfizer, they are selling vaccines for cost in developing worlds. They're making no profit at all. And they are pretty good at manufacturing. You saw what had happened here in the United States. One of our biggest manufacturing plants has still not had one dose, and we had to throw out 15 million doses from that emergent plant in Maryland. It is hard to manufacture these. So that administration, I mean, the decision on the patents, I don't think it's going to make any impact in the short run. What we need is to continue manufacturing vaccines and then to distribute them in the right places in the right way.
Do you worry that we're opening up too soon in this country? I know we're all COVID tired. I get it, myself included. But do you worry that we're opening up too early since so many people still haven't gotten the vaccine? I was in a car the other day and I just casually asked the driver, have you had a vaccine? And he said, no. And I just, I was very unsettled by it.
Yeah, you know, if you look at the data in the United Kingdom and Israel, where certain areas are way ahead of us in vaccines, if we can get our numbers 15% higher, so vaccinate 15% more people in the United States, mm-hmm. our virus numbers will fall almost 15-fold. And that's mm-hmm. where we really need to get to.
So whatever the new normal is, when do we get there?
My hope is we can get there by the beginning of the summer, but we have to continue vaccinating.
What's the beginning of the summer?
Beginning of the summer is going to be, you know, the end of June. And I think that if we can get 12 to 15, which should be approved in the next several days, that age group, that's another 17 million kids right there. That's going to help get us there. We have to continue pushing for the vaccination.
What's the percentage we need to get to, in your view?
I think if we can get to the low 70s, we're going to be in a really good spot. And then we're going to have the boosters, which will come along in, you know, probably toward the end of the year, to keep the immunity to these new variants.
We are going to have to have boosters.
Most of the population will have boosters.
Dr. David Agus, thanks so much.
It's so
helpful.
Good to see you guys.
Yeah,
I got to hug
him.
I got to hug him. I got to touch him. It was so good.
Wait, I don't think you're...
All right.